Hi everyone, welcome back. In the previous video I show you how to make tasks and how to use them in quest, how they work a bit as condition and how to make some branches. And in this video I'm gonna explain more about tasks, but in this case I'm gonna use a custom structure inside them. I'm gonna make some basic logic with it, and I'm also gonna show you how to customize the editor for that particular task. So the idea is I'm gonna make every widget possible for this customization of the editor. Usually you don't do this, you can reuse them, they are very modular, so they are possible to use in many other tasks, not just one. So that's the idea. The first thing we're gonna do is just create a structure, because we don't have any in this project. So I'm gonna go to the quest folder, tasks, again task. I'm gonna make a new folder, I'm gonna call this item task, and I'm gonna make a structure. So go to blueprints, structure, I'm gonna call this one item. Of course this is just a name, should to have some context or nothing important. Go to variables, I'm gonna set this one to string, this is gonna be the name. I'm gonna add a new one, this is gonna be description. I'm gonna add a new one, this is gonna be just image texture 2D. So let's search for texture 2D, this is gonna be the image. And the last one is integer, this is gonna be the amount. So now we have a custom structure. You will have in your game, of course, many of those. You will want to use them, so this is gonna be the example for that. I'm gonna go to the task, I'm gonna make a new child from the base task, this is just for consistency. Create a blueprint child, I'm gonna call this task underscore item, and I'm gonna move it to the item task folder. So move here, here we have the task, I'm gonna open it. For this particular task I'm just gonna override onQuest task activated, this is the main logic, and in this particular case we're gonna use the custom structure data. So this is something that comes with the plugin. If you type payload, you will see that there are some functions for the payload data. You can get the custom payload data for all the different data from the array, or if you type again payload data, you can get by index. This is just the same like doing this. This is exactly the same, it's a shortcut. We're gonna use this one. Because we're gonna use just one structure, we're gonna have only one payload data, so it's gonna be an index 0. We need to convert it to a structure. So I'm gonna type again payload. And you can see there is two functions here, payload data to struct, and struct to payload data. So this is gonna be payload data to a structure, we're gonna convert it to a structure that we can read. I'm gonna connect the data there, and for the structure we need to know what we are doing here. So we know this structure is gonna be an item, so I'm gonna add it, I'm gonna add a variable, I'm gonna call the variable item, and I'm gonna change the type to item2. I'm gonna drag it holding control, and I'm gonna connect it to the structure. So what this function is doing is populating this new variable that we created with the data from the editor or from the data tables. So this particular task is not gonna do much, it's gonna just print all the information from the structure, so you can see it. I'm gonna append, I'm gonna add some pins, and of course I'm gonna add some time, so it prints a bit longer. And for now, I'm gonna break the item that it already contains the variables. And I'm gonna say, well, this is name. So I'm gonna connect the name. This is gonna be description. I'm gonna connect the description. And this one is gonna be amount. I'm gonna connect the amount there. So basically we are just printing the data, and of course the task always has to end, so let's call the endQuestTask function. I'm gonna connect it. is just a true value. So this is print task. I should name it like that. Compile and save. And we have already now the task created that uses this this structure. So you go to the data table for task. So in the quest folder, data tables, task. We have this one with the jump task from the other video. We're gonna add a new one. This is gonna be the print item. Print item. I'm gonna set the color something different from the other one. Let's use red. And for the task class, the one that we should create, this is the task item. So if we save. I'm gonna close it. I'm gonna open the editor. This is of course a reset because I delete the save. Let's go to quest. I'm gonna add a new quest. I'm gonna call this quest item. I'm gonna save it right away to the data table quest. So remember you have to select it and save. And I'm gonna add some nodes. So for the task, I'm gonna just hold Alt and click. And for the task that I'm gonna be item, I'm gonna control click, and this is the task. I'm gonna connect those, pressing C after selecting them. I'm gonna align them with Q, and I'm gonna set the talk information. So the example is the NPC is gonna be example NPC. I'm gonna just fill the fields. So this is the item quest, and I'm gonna just type here something. That's nice. I'm just gonna type something. So now, if we want to set the task, we go to task. This is the data table, and we have the print item task. So if you click it, you don't see anything. You don't see errors. You don't see anything in the node. You don't see a title or a content like these ones. And of course, you cannot set any variables. So this is because we haven't set this yet in the data tables. So for now, I'm just gonna save the quest, and I'm gonna add it to the NPC just to have it already. Not forget. So let's go set the NPC for the quest data table should quest item quest and add it and should save. So now we have the NPC saved with the quest. Of course, this task already needs some other widgets, so we're gonna make those. Gonna go back to the task folder where we have the item task, and now we're gonna create a selector, so a widget for us to be able to set the variables in the editor in the details panel. So this is gonna be a custom payload selector. Let's go to blueprint class and let's type custom payload selector. This last one, selector widget. Let's select that, and I'm gonna call this selector underscore item, just to have a name. Let's open it, and of course it's a widget, so we're gonna have to populate it. Let's go to add a vertical box. I'm gonna do this very quickly because this is not just a tutorial for widgets. I'm gonna try and explain a bit. So the editor has already some header or widget that I use, so to have it look a bit like it or to have some consistency in the detail panel, I'm gonna just use those. This is the general header I'm gonna add first. I'm gonna call this item data just to have a title. And now there is one widget from Epic that is called something with view. Is this one a detail view? This allows you to see several variables at the same time, and this one allows you to just see one. We're gonna use this one, the detail view, that allows you to see many. I'm gonna add it to the vertical box. I'm gonna add some padding to it, so let's put 5 here. And for now, that's it. Let's compile and save. I'm gonna go to the graph. So for this particular case, I'm not gonna use these ones. So delete this. And for the functions, there is one that we need to override. This is called update from data, it's the last one. So let's click on it. And this, as you can see, there is an update event that is giving you some information. So with this information, we need to update the widget. But first, we know this is an item. So I'm going to make a variable. I'm going to call this variable item, and from the same type, item. And now, as we did in the task, we're going to go and say payload and payload data to a structure. So we're going to convert this data to a structure. The structure is going to be the item, and the data, oops, it's not moving, and the data is going to be the one that the event is committing. So because the detail view work a bit weird, at least in this version, we're gonna need to do some extra work here. So I'm gonna need some variables. I'm gonna need variables for each of this structure. Of course, this is because we are using the detail view. If you are using another widget, text, combo box, thing like that, of course this is gonna be different. But for this particular case, we're gonna need all these variables. So I'm gonna create them. I'm gonna create it item name. I'm gonna set it to a string. We're gonna need item description. We're gonna need the item image. This is gonna be a texture 2D. Let's select that. And the last one is item amount, and it's an integer. So I'm gonna make all these variables go to a category. I'm gonna call this category shootItem, and let's drag all these variables to the category. So if you compile and save, and remember the category is item. So if you go to the designer, in the details view, you can say what category you want to show for the variables. So I'm gonna add one. I'm gonna say this is the item category that you created. I'm gonna save, and now I'm gonna continue to update the event. So in this case, I'm gonna set every one of these variables. So I'm gonna hold Alt and I'm gonna drag them, and it's gonna create these little nodes. I'm gonna connect all of those, and I'm gonna drag from the structure and connect it to the each of the variables. So now we have the variables set differently in this another individual ones. So let's call this set variables, and we need something else for the detail view to work. We need to force an update somehow. This is the only way I found yet. Of course, this one are very early, so I'm expecting they change a bit. But for now, I'm gonna set the object. And if you set the object to null, it's gonna clear every variable. And if you set it again, but with the reference from this widget, so I'm gonna type self, this is gonna update. So this is the only way I found. So let's update. And of course, this is only the event for updating all the widget. But we still need some event for when the variables change, and we need to set in the task. So for that, in the selectors, we have a function that is selector commit value, as you can see here. And in these particular selectors, you can plug whatever structure you have. So I'm gonna make a structure. I'm gonna make item. This is the structure. And I'm gonna use all of these individual variables. I'm gonna set it so like that. And of course, we still need some event that tells us when this variable change. This is already in the details view. If you click it, you will see this event on property change. It doesn't matter which one. We're gonna update the editor. So we're gonna connect that, and this is updating variables. So that's it for the selector. So let's compile, let's save. I'm gonna close this one, and I'm gonna go to the data table for task again. So it's this one. If you select print item here, and for the custom payload selector, I'm gonna add one. And this one is going to be the one that we created, selector item. So I'm going to choose save now. I'm going to close this and I'm going to open the editor again. So now, if you click the task, this is the question that we were doing. If you click the task, it's print item, and now we can see all the variables. So I'm going to set this one. I'm going to call the item dagger. I'm going to set the description. This is a common dagger. I'm going to set an image. Gonna be this thing, and I'm gonna set the amount to 5. So now, of course, you can see that the variables change, but you are not seeing anything in Node. If you click somewhere else, for example, in this task, you will see that. If you click again, you see that the variables are set, but you still cannot see them in the Node. This is because we don't have any content or title for the Node set. So we're gonna create that now. I'm gonna close this. So now we're gonna go to the task folder, item task, and I'm gonna right click it. I'm gonna go to blueprint class. I'm gonna go and search for base task, and we can see here the content and the title preview. So I'm gonna create a content. Let's select that. Let's call this content underscore item. I'm gonna open it, and I'm gonna add some widgets. So let's go for a vertical box. Let's add a text. I'm gonna set font a bit lower, like that. Go center. This text is gonna be the item name. I'm gonna add an image. So the image is gonna be also in the vertical box. It's gonna be also centered. And I'm gonna grab it with the size box. I'm gonna say this is overrided to 60 there, and we can add some another text. So this is just to have something to see. Of course, you can make anything you want here. This is gonna be the amount text. It's gonna be variable. This image is variable too. Okay, let's lower the bit of the font. And I'm gonna make this have some padding, so let's set 5 there. So this is very basic, of course, you can do much better ones. So for the graph now, we're not gonna use any of these, so let's delete them. And what we're gonna use is the function, if you go to override, that is named update preview widget, so we're gonna click those. And we need the task information, so for this we're gonna go search quest task, and if you scroll down there is a variable and it's get quest task. So this calls in this widgets all the information that you need to update it. So for us now we have the information in the custom payload, so I'm gonna get, of course, there is zero value is where everything is for the item now. So I'm gonna use this one, I'm gonna convert it to the actual item struct. So let's go to payload data to structure. I'm gonna set it, I'm gonna go and create a new variable, it's gonna be item. Just like we did before, this is not new. I'm gonna connect it here. And now I'm gonna drag all these things that we added in the hierarchy of the widget. And we're gonna update them. So the item name is a text. Let's set text. Let's go and break the item. The name is just directly the name. Let's move those. So we have the name text. We're gonna set the amount text. So let's set text. The amount is gonna be that one, and for the image we're gonna set brush set brush from texture. So it is one, let's plug in there, and this is gonna update all the widget. So that's it. Let's comment this one, set update, and that's it for the content widget. It's very simple. I'm gonna create the title one now, so let's go to blueprint class, base task, and already you can see it here, base task, title preview. Let's select that, and this is gonna be title underscore item. This is gonna be even more simple. Let's add a border, just to have some color. This is gonna be the border, outline, and I'm gonna add some text. Let's type text here. Let's add it. I'm gonna set to 20, and this is gonna be the variable, and this is gonna be the text block task name. So let's see, it's a variable. Yes, let's compile and save it. And now we're gonna go to the graph. Of course, we don't need those. I'm gonna go to override, and this is the same event that we override in the content. So let's go for it again here. So for this particular one, I'm gonna use another function that is getTaskInfo. This is something that there is already in the preview slots. Let's break the info. And you can see this is the information from the data table. So I have the task name and I have the task color. So I'm gonna use those. So for the text that set name, I'm gonna set text. Set text. It's gonna be task name. Let's connect it. And for the border color, I'm gonna set the color directly. Set brush color, I'm gonna connect it, and that's it. I'm gonna set this the update, and we have already the content and the title. So let's close this and let's go back to the task data table, and we're gonna set those. So for the title preview widget, this is the sham one. Let's go to print item. And title preview, we're gonna set the title item, and in content preview widget, we're gonna set the item one to the content item. So now we have the content and the title in the node. Let's open the editor again, and now you can see the node has something to show. It's showing dagger, of course, it's showing the image. And it's showing, of course, the number and the print item task name. So now there is one thing missing here, where we need some errors to show in case someone makes some mistakes. So I'm gonna close this one. I'm gonna go back to the item folder, item task. And for errors, it's more simple. Let's go to quest category. And we have the quest task error object. So this is the one that we create now. I'm gonna call this error underscore item. I'm gonna open it. And this one has only one function. So get error from task. So you can see here, you have some variables. You're gonna have to use those. Of course, this is the quest task, similarly to what we've seen in the last widgets. We have the task and we have the editor information, and you have two output variables. So this is the error and this is the color. So if you return an empty string, this is not going to show an error, and if you set something here, it's going to show an error with this color. So for this one, I'm going to drag the quest task. I'm going to get the zero from the payload. Let's make it a reference. And we're gonna convert it to a structure. So data, payload data to a structure. Of course, we need a variable. We're gonna make a local variable item, and we're gonna set it to item. And I'm gonna drag it with control. I'm gonna connect it, and this is populating the structure. So get data. And now, well, you need to get creative. So we're gonna detect the error here. So if this is equal to empty string, we're gonna say okay, there is no name, no name set. I'm gonna set it to red. Otherwise, I'm gonna copy it. If the description is not set, equal to null, no description. I'm gonna set here no description set. If the image is, I'm gonna go to is valid. So if the image is valid, everything is okay. If it's not valid, I'm gonna set invalid image. I'm gonna set some other color here. So let's put a yellow one. The image is not that important. So, and of course, if the image is correct, I'm gonna go and say, okay, is this less than zero? So if you set the amount negative, that's an error. Let's say. So amount is negative, and I'm gonna set this one to another color. And of course, if nothing, none of this is true, I'm just gonna return an empty string. Okay, and I'm gonna connect here. Of course, I don't forget to do that. So that's the error object. That's it. I'm gonna compile and save and close this, and I'm gonna go back to the task data table. I'm gonna set those. You can see the errors. If you select the print item, you can see the errors. You can add many. This is because they are made to, so you can reuse them a lot. Of course, we only have one now, so we're gonna use that. The error item, I'm gonna save, and I'm gonna go back to the editor. And if you see here, we have no error. That's because everything is okay. But for example, if I go to a negative number, now I see an error. The amount is negative, and we see the color that we set. Of course, not gonna have that. Let's go back to 5. And now we have pretty much everything. But we can add some tooltip, so that's what we're gonna do next. So let's close this one. Let's go to the back to the item task, and I'm gonna create a new blueprint class. It's gonna be base tooltip content widget. It is one. Let's select that, and I'm gonna call this tooltip underscore item. So this is gonna be ugly. It's gonna be a vertical box. Let's add some text, because the image is already showing. I'm just gonna add another one. I'm just gonna make it very quick. This is gonna be the name, item name is variable. I'm gonna lower the font size a bit, gonna be that, and this one too. This is gonna be the description. So in the content we didn't show the description. So this is mostly for it. And I'm gonna grab it with the border. So let's add border, let's add some color to it. Let's gonna go and set the alpha to half. So yeah, of course the tooltip, this one is gonna look very ugly. let's delete this, I don't need it. And for the update, update tooltip widget. And of course, this is a payload tooltip, so we are expecting to have data in the form of a payload. So get payload, and we're gonna see this variable. I break this, and of course, you see a payload structure. So for this one, I'm gonna use the string A to pass the custom data to the tooltip. I'm gonna just go and search for payload data to structure. Let's connect that way. I'm gonna add a variable, it's gonna be item again. Let's shoot item. Let's add it. And now we have the data from the item. So let's break it. And we're gonna set the item name and description. So those are text. Let's set text. Let's copy that one. And should connect it. And I'm gonna connect those. So now we have a way to update the widget. Let's compile and save. But we still need to send the data. Of course, we're gonna add this tooltip to the content. So let's go back to the content item widget, and I'm gonna make sure that this one is not visible. Let's go to the visibility settings and set not hit testable, and of course for the other one too. So the image is the only thing that's gonna hit the mouse, and of course you're gonna trigger the tooltip. So for the tooltip we're gonna need some events. So let's go and search for mouse enter and on mouse leave. So this is for the widget to control the tooltip. We're gonna need a quest editor reference. This widget already have one quest editor reference, and this one has an event that is show tooltip, and it looks like that. We're gonna need the tooltip that we want to show. It's gonna be the tooltip item, and the information is gonna be in a form of payload. So this is how it looks like. I'm gonna move the event a bit here, and we use the string A for that. And in that string, we need the custom payload data. So this is the one that we need. I'm gonna copy it. I'm gonna paste here, and I'm gonna connect it to the string A. And of course, I'm gonna connect the event. And for hiding the tooltip, there is a similar event that is hide tooltip. Let's gonna call it, and that's it. We are now controlling the tooltip with these ones. So tooltip. Let's compile and save it. And now, if we go to the quest editor, we will see the tooltip in the top left. This that is says dagger, and this is a common dagger. That is the description that we said before. So that's all the widgets and the object that we needed to create. So the last part is test this quest. So let's save. Let's save all, and let's hit play. I'm gonna maximize this, and if you go to the NPC, this is the quest item, of course. If you click it, you see the task is printing all the information. It's name dagger, description common dagger, find the amount of amount, and that's it. So it works. You can complete the quest if you want. So that's it for this video. It's a pretty long video, but it shows everything for customizing the editor and using structures in your task. So thanks for watching. Bye.